तो टॉप टू बॉटम होता है. फंक्शंस कैन बी कैटेगराइज एज थ्री मॉड्यूल्स बिल्ट इन एंड यूजर डिफाइंड. तीन टाइप के फंक्शंस हम लोग करेंगे. अ मॉड्यूल इज अ फाइल कंटेनिंग पाइथन डेफिनेशंस दैट इज फंक्शंस एंड स्टेटमेंट्स. स्टैंडर्ड लाइब्रेरी ऑफ पाइथन इज एक्सटेंडेड एज मॉड्यूल्स टू अ प्रोग्रामर. डेफिनेशंस फ्रॉम द मॉड्यूल कैन बी यूज्ड विद इन द कोड ऑफ अ प्रोग्राम. To use these modules in the program, a programmer needs to import the module. जो रेडीमेड मॉड्यूल्स होते हैं या फिर हम जो बनाएंगे अभी उसको .py करके सेव करेंगे तो उसको हम इम्पोर्ट करना पड़ेगा. जैसे इम्पोर्ट मैथ करके मैथ मॉड्यूल के सारे फंक्शंस को हम यूज़ करते हैं. नेक्स्ट, हाउ टू इम्पोर्ट मॉड्यूल. इम्पोर्ट करने के लिए दो मेथड है. देर आर मैनी वेज टू इम्पोर्ट अ मॉड्यूल इन योर प्रोग्राम. द वंस विच यू शुड नो आर इम्पोर्ट एंड फ्रॉम. बहुत सारे मेथड्स से मेनी वेज है बट वी विल यूज ओनली इम्पोर्ट एंड फ्रॉम. सो टू मेथड्स वी विल लर्न. नाउ हाउ टू यूज इम्पोर्ट. इम्पोर्ट वी कैन डायरेक्टली राइट हियर इम्पोर्ट मैथ, इम्पोर्ट मॉड्यूल नेम, मॉड्यूल टू, मॉड्यूल थ्री एंड सो ऑन. नेक्स्ट, फॉर यूजिंग द फंक्शन वी विल यूज दिस वॉट एवर यू हैव इम्पोर्टेड दैट मॉड्यूल नेम डॉट द फंक्शन नेम एंड द आर्ग्यूमेंट्स. लाइक दिस वी आर राइटिंग. जैसे इसमें स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 25 निकालना है तो मैथ मॉड्यूल का फंक्शन SQRT मैंने यूज़ किया 25, तो वैल्यू के पास 5 आ जाएगा. स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ 25 इज 5, सो इट विल गिव 5. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज फ्रॉम. फ्रॉम को कैसे यूज़ करते हैं. फ्रॉम मैथ इम्पोर्ट SQRT. सपोज इन मैथ देयर आर मेनी फंक्शंस SQRT, पाव, पावर, देन सील, फ्लोर, साइन, कॉस, मेनी फंक्शंस आर देयर. आई वॉन्ट टू इम्पोर्ट ओनली SQRT. सो वॉट आई विल राइट, फ्रॉम मैथ इम्पोर्ट SQRT. नाउ यू डोंट हैव टू राइट मैथ डॉट SQRT. नाउ डायरेक्टली वी विल राइट SQRT बिकॉज ओनली वन फंक्शन यू हैव इम्पोर्टेड. If you write here import like in the previous one you were writing import math, in that you have to write math.sqrt. Here directly SQRT you can write. Clear? Now there are so many math functions, like one by one you can do it. Seal will give the upper limit, floor will give the lower limit. So these you have to calculate it. Next, power will give you the power of one number to the power of the second number. Then absolute value is there, square root is there, log, cos, sine, tan. Clear? Now random module. In random module we will do only random, randint and rand range. This is equivalent to rand range uniform. So random will give you from 0 to 1, any value in between it will give. Next, randint will include A and B and it will give all the values, any values between A and B, including these two. Whereas in rand range, it will exclude rand range or uniform. We will use rand range here. So in rand range, we will exclude the outer one from the beginning, from A till 1 less than B, it will give any, return any value. How to create Python modules. So you will create, practically we will do it now using def. You will create it and then you will save it with PI and you will then import that file and you will use it. Next is, like here it is given, see the example here, how to create a function. We will write here def keyword. So def, then give a space and any identifier, any name you can write here. So I have used here any identifier. It should start with the alphabet or underscore and it can contain in it numbers. First letter cannot be a number, it will be alphabet or underscore with the parenthesis, and block, def block is starting as a colon, and the block we will write here, and when we will call this world here, it will display hello world. Clear? So here how to call function. Now, in the previous one, if you have saved it with the hello.py, suppose that program you have saved with hello.py, now you have to, in any other program, when you will open the IDLE or you will open any script mode, you have to write import hello and then you have to call here hello.world. This is how to create your own module and how to save it and then how to call it. So here you can see you have created here def world, you have created this and then you have imported it and you have called the function. How to call it? फंक्शन नेम इज वर्ल्ड ऑफ हेलो मॉड्यूल. सो मॉड्यूल नेम डॉट फंक्शन नेम हेलो डॉट वर्ल्ड इन द मेन प्रोग्राम. नाउ बिल्ट इन फंक्शन. बिल्ट इन फंक्शंस आर द फंक्शंस दैट आर बिल्ट इन टू पाइथन एंड कैन बी एक्सेस्ड बाई अ प्रोग्रामर. दीज आर ऑलवेज अवेलेबल एंड फॉर यूजिंग देम वी डू नॉट हैव टू इम्पोर्ट एनी मॉड्यूल. क्लियर. सो हियर डायरेक्टली बिल्ट इन फंक्शंस वी विल यूज़ एंड यू डोंट हैव टू इम्पोर्ट एनी डायरेक्टली लाइक टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू इंट वी आर यूजिंग इंट. टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू स्ट्रिंग वी आर यूजिंग स्ट्रिंग. सो दिस इज टाइप कन्वर्जन्स. देन इन फ्रंट ऑफ इट फ्लोट इफ यू राइट इट विल कन्वर्ट इट इन टू फ्लोट. क्लियर. सो इन फ्रंट ऑफ एनी वैल्यू इन एनी स्ट्रिंग एनी दिस इफ यू राइट फ्लोट इट विल कन्वर्ट इट इन टू फ्लोट. Then input function, if you write input here, automatically it takes as input whatever user will enter. Now here, absolute, max, min, compare. So these are your built-in functions, ready-made functions. You don't have to import anything directly. You can use in Python. So Python gives you these many built-in functions. Clear? So this is, once you do it practically, I will show it practically also. Now user defined function, that those were built in functions which we don't have to write the program. But user defined function means I want to create my own function. I don't want to use a built in function. So I will create a user defined function. To define a function, keyword def is used. Now this is very important, def keyword for defining any function. After the keyword comes an identifier, that is the name of the function, followed by the parenthesis, list of parameters and the colon which ends up the line, optional documentation string, whatever comment you want to write. Next follows the block of the statement that are the part of the function, an optional return statement to return a value from the function. If you want to print in that block, you can print it. If you want to return to the main program some values or directly return, you can use here. It is optional, it is not compulsion, it is an optional return statement. So here you can see how to write. You will use the word def. Def is the keyword here, this is compulsory. Then any name, any identifiers. Then in parenthesis, comma separated list of arguments. Suppose you are calculating the square of a number, only one argument. Two arguments, suppose you want to display the sum of two numbers. Let us do practically, then you will understand. Examples, def functions. So here def, you have written here print. I am learning functions in Python. When you are calling this function here, this is function call statement. So when you are calling or invoking a function, it will print I am learning. So it will search for the function, it will go there and it will print whatever is given here. It will do that task. This is a doc string, that is any argument you can give here, comment you can give here. So this is my first. So here you have given a doc string. Next, how function returns a value. So here in def, when you are calculating any value, return value will return to the main program, and here one variable is required to collect the value. Like suppose in this question it is returning the area. So you have given the argument here, this is function header, def identifier, and in this length and breadth you have given, area is length into breadth. Now you are returning area. So when you will return area, where in the main program one variable should be there to collect that return value. So these all programs, it is given at the end of the book. I will share this also. You solve these programs. If you have any doubt, mention in the comment box. Now parameters and arguments in function. Now this is very important. Parameters are the values provided in the parenthesis when we write function header. So in the function header, in the parenthesis, all the values which we are comma separated parameters which we are writing. So those are called parameters. They are also called arguments. These are the values required by function to work. Suppose the question is sum of two numbers, the two numbers if you require. So you will put in the parenthesis a comma b and it will be taken from the main program. If there is more than one value required by a function to work upon, then all of them will be listed in parameters list separated by comma. So it is comma separated parameters. You can see here for simple interest, we require principal, rate and time. So here we have written the three parameters and it is returning this value. After calculating, it is returning. So it will return the simple interest where principal is 30,000, rate is 20 and time is 5. Clear. Now there are different types of arguments: positional argument, default argument, keyword arguments and variable length arguments. In your syllabus you are having positional argument and default arguments. Positional arguments means the first value will be given to the first argument, second will be given to the second arguments. This is the positional arguments. Default arguments means if equals to sign you have written and you have given a default value, even if you don't pass the value, like in the first one we have given only welcome. Welcome is given to message but times is not mentioned. So times, what it will do, it will take the default value. Now welcome into times is 1, so it will print once welcome. In the second one, hello comma 2. So message is hello. When you pass this 2 to times, then it will not take the default value. Default value it will take only when no value is passed to it. So here 2 it will be given to times. Now hello into 2 means 2 times it will print hello. So this is your default argument. This is very important. In board exam, one question will be asked in output question also from this default argument. So you go through this default argument where equals to sign is used while in the function header to give the values to default values to the arguments or parameters. Next, default argument. Suppose here you have given name equals to Raju and message equals to good morning. Means two default arguments you have used. If no value is passed, like here greet, no value is passed. Now it will take by default Raju and by default message will be good morning. So hello, name will be Raju and message will be good morning. So hello Raju, good morning. But if you are passing Navya and by, clear? Now what it will print? Hello Navya by. Now third one is you are passing only Mohit and you are not passing anything to message. So here in name Mohit will be there and in message by default it will take good morning. So hello Mohit, good morning. Clear? Next is keyword arguments. So here keyword arguments means suppose you have given name and message and I want to give first value to message. So here MSG good morning I have written, this keyword I have used here, MSG I have used here. So I am giving the message first value. Normally it is positional. The first value is given to the first argument, first parameter. But in this case what I have done, like in the previous one, Rosie and good morning, this is positional argument. Rosie will be given to name and good morning will be given to message. But in this, message equals to good morning means this is keyword argument. To message I will give good morning and to name I will give Rosie. So these are the keyword arguments. So this is the examples. Now what are the advantages? So directly which all values, suppose there are many arguments and you want to give values to only two of them. So positional means normally first argument is given the first value. So position you have to follow. I don't want to follow the position. I want to give the argument as my own wish. So I will use here keyword arguments. Clear? Now this is not asked so much. So we are skipping this keyword arguments. Variable length is not in your syllabus. Next, passing arrays, list to function. This is important. Now when you are passing a complete list to a function, simply what you have to take? You have to take the list from the user and while calling the function you will pass here. See, the argument is list. List contains a heterogeneous value. So many values of different data types are there. Now using the index value you can access here each and every element. While doing the practical in details we will see. Now this is very important. Two question was given in sample question paper. So first question was, what is the difference between global and local scope? Scope means where you can use these variables, the scope of the variables. One is your local scope and one is your global scope. Local scope means local, private. It is in which in the function, if it is the variable is used in a block or function, then it can be used only in that block. It cannot be used in other blocks. Whereas global scope means if it is variable is given a value or variable is used outside the block or program or functions, then it is global scope. It can be used by every part of your program. So all the functions can use it. Clear? Now the difference, this is asked. So this is very important. You note it down in your copy. It is a variable which is declared within a block or within a function. It is a variable which is declared outside all the functions. So this is the first difference. Local variable is declared within a block and global is declared outside. It is accessible only within a function, block program. It is accessible throughout. Kahin pe bhi use kar sakte hain. Clear? So this is very important. Ye bahut important question hai. Iske do difference aur example note kar lo. पहला डिफरेंस क्या है कि इट इज़ डिक्लेयर्ड विद इन अ ब्लॉक, किसी ब्लॉक के अंदर इसका डिक्लेरेशन होता है, या आउटसाइड द फंक्शन, फंक्शन के बाहर ये डिक्लेयर होता है. एक्सेसिबल ओनली, ये खाली फंक्शन और ब्लॉक के अंदर एक्सेस कर सकते हैं, और ये थ्रू आउट द प्रोग्राम, पूरे प्रोग्राम में जितने ब्लॉक्स हैं सब लोग एक्सेस कर सकते हैं. क्लियर? नाउ द एग्जाम्पल, यू कैन सी हियर एक्स इक्वल्स टू 50, इट इज़ आउटसाइड दिस ब्लॉक, दिस डेफ text block. So when you are printing outside here, anywhere inside also it will print 50, and value of x is outside also it will print 50. So in both the cases, inside test block also it is 50 and outside also it is 50. This is global scope. Local scope means, like here x is 50, y is 20. Now when you are printing inside, it will print 20, and if you are printing the value of x inside, it will not print because x is not having the value here. Clear? So if you write here x will be printed, sorry, y will not be printed here outside, because y is having a local scope. Local scope means it will be used only in this block. Outside the block it will not have value. यहाँ पे y को हमने outside the block use किया है, और ये declare कहाँ पे है, value इसके पास कहाँ पे दिया गया है, inside. तो यहाँ पे error दिखाएगा. क्यों? क्योंकि ये def के बाहर हम y को use नहीं कर सकते हैं, जबकि x को हम अंदर भी use कर सकते हैं और बाहर भी use कर सकते हैं. Now these are the practice sessions. You go through all the programs which is given in your book, and in your NCERT book also, it is provided by NCERT. You can search. I will give you the link of the book. So you just solve all the questions. Now this is in different sections. So today till in function only built-in and user-defined we were having.